my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, I give you praise, my God. Oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, oh my soul, praise the Lord. Praise the King of Kings, oh my soul. Mandala la maso tara ba 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 ba. Le boso na la la ba ya. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh my soul. Praise the Lord. You deserve the glory. You deserve all the honor. You deserve all my praise. For you alone, I call. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Jesus, we love you. Jesus, we honor you. Jesus, we praise you. We lift our voice to you and we declare you as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We honor you and we worship you for the time and opportunity given unto us. Now we will come before your throne of mercy and be partakers of your glory. Now we reveal your divine purpose and divine agenda unto us, O God. We never thought that you can love us to that extent. How can you love us in this manner? The Bible teaches us what manner of love that the Father has bestowed upon us. That we will be called the sons of God. Oh, what a privilege. Oh, what peace we love in for our feet. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus. Whoa, what a friend we have in you. Oh, what a friend. Oh, what a friend. What a friend. If this truth is rejected now, it will definitely and suddenly going to be accepted after one has entered into eternal home. But it will be too late to walk away according to what Jesus has said. because there is no repentance after death. Ladies and gentlemen, let us stop defending our false belief and our doctrines and the religion that many people have held on to and have destroyed their life eternally. God is God. He will never reduce the standard because of you and me. The counsel of God shall ever remain. The plans and the purpose of God will remain unchanged. If you don't believe, if the gospel is veiled, Apostle Paul said that it is veiled for those people that the prince of this world has blindfolded them. Though that the prince of this world have covered their understanding, and because of that, seeing the truth they see, but they cannot perceive. Hearing the truth they hear, but they don't have the strength and the urge to pursue that. This morning, it is my prayer. It is my prayer for you to know divine secret that has been unveiled to the end time believers. And some of us, we are bold because we are not bound by the religion and the doctrines. Beloved, we have been deceived in many cases. We have been deceived. The modern Christianity, the New Age type of Christianity, has deceived most of us. But thank be to God. Thank be to God. Thank be to God. Yesterday I gave you the lies and the deception of the motivational speakers and preachers in our days. Beloved, truth will never cease. Truth will always prevail. To go to heaven is one thought. To go to hell is a thought. It's a thought. It's a thought. Satan was banned or was forbidden from heaven because of one thought. But when we speak the truth to you, there are some people who fight against it. It's a thought. It's a thought. It's not a far. It's not far at all. Your husband can lead you easily. Your wife can lead you easily. Your anger, your unforgiveness, your bitterness, your lustful, your ardor in your heart, your lack of faith. You are disobedient to the principles and the counsel of God. I won't do it. I want to do it on my way. Oh God. Sometimes when you are tired, you become upset or one reason or little things, and you become angry towards your children, towards your spouse, towards your colleague, you are out. You are out. Be angry but don't sin. Even in your anger, in a period that you are struggling one way or the other, people, we have been deceived by the unveiled gospel. You go to people for prayer to become rich. Prayer doesn't make a person rich. Prayer gives you direction. Dr. Mark Mudok, one of the motivational speakers, he said that if one go to God to ask him for a miracle, God will give him an instructions. Why? Because instructions that you follow determine the future that you create. Our problem is not that we are not praying.
We are praying, but we are not going to the direction. We are not receiving because we are not applying the principles and the direction that God points out to us. The word of God says that, and you shall hear the voice of the Lord telling you to go to the left or to the right. Most people are not willing to go to the left and right, but we are interested in praying. There is nothing wrong. God is not hearing because the Bible says that God is not deaf, that he can't hear us. But our iniquity has blocked us. There is a blessing blocker. And that is all of my messages. Remove the blessing blocker. Remove the hindrances. Remove things that blocks you from entering into where God is. As simple as ABCD. When iniquity is removed out of your life, when sin is removed out of your life, when the hindrances of the enemy desires your passion, your want, your ways, when it is taken off from God's ways, brother, I tell you, the healing that you are praying for will come. The joy that you are praying for will come. The money that you are praying for will come. Because God is going to give you directions. God is going to give you a favor of a new contract. That money will not come into your pocket as some thieves are doing it. God is not a magician. Now somebody will pray, Lord, add money into the accounts. Hey, Kwaku. Then why do you take collection? If God can add money into your accounts, into people's account, why do you ask people to pay tithe in your church? Why don't you ask God to add, or God doesn't want to add some to yours? The devil is a liar. And there are some people who have very slow mindset to believe such deception and false. Even Jesus Christ, Peter came to him one time and said, Lord, we need to pay tax. Jesus gave him an instructions. Peter, go into the sea. Go and catch fish. And the first fish that you catch, there is a gold coin in his mouth. Take it. Go and pay yours and mine. Hey. Even Jesus had to command Peter to go and work. That was the way that Peter has been paying his tax. So Jesus said, following me doesn't change the process. Peter, go and catch the fish. Go and catch the fish. Do what you used to do to get money. Don't go and steal. Don't go and borrow. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the hidden truth that people are not ready to listen to. But beloved, God will never change it. God will never change it. God will never change it. What he has said, he will do it. What he has said, he will do it. What he has said, he will do it. Let us come out of these things. Let us come out of these things. Because the enemy, the enemy, our advocate, he is doing everything possible to cause our understanding to swift. To cause our understanding to swift. That we will be led astray. It is my prayer that every day as you listen to End Time Radio, your life will always be in check. That you put your life in your hands. This morning my message is why you need to be born again. Why you need to be established. Why you need to totally dedicate your life to Christ. I was once listening to a man of God, and he said something that shook my understanding. He said that the most miserable people, this man was an occult grandmaster converted into Christianity. He said the people who are very miserable is the people who serve God, who are in the house of God every day, but they are playing God. Darling, my message is just telling you, quit playing games with your belief system. Quit playing games with your salvation. The time to play church is over. The time to play church is over. The time to play church is over. Oh, Jesus. Do away with any artificial introduction or application or any parts of your body that defiles your righteousness and your holiness in the sight of God. Beloved, the time has come. The time has come that believers need to be firm, strong, and to become born again. The time to become born again for real is now. Because if you die in your sin, you will come face to face with Satan. Countless demons and dragons, gigantic snake, and unnameable creatures who will torment you day in and day out forever and ever. Are you willing to risk your life for these people? Hell is not a place for you. But I want to tell you, hell is real. Your unbelief doesn't change it, because God has made it so. For the fact that you don't see it physically doesn't mean that it's not there, because you don't see air. But you feel air every day. Ladies and gentlemen, there are some of us, we are so afraid with even little insects. My children are very, very afraid of spider. If they see spider in the room, they won't go there. A mere spider. Mere spider. I don't blame them, because when I was a little child, I was also afraid of millipede. Kankabi. When we were little children, we were afraid of little insects that cannot bite us. This fear is still there. Some people are phobia and things that people are afraid of in life. And you can imagine, darling, have this picture that this insect that you are afraid of, you have them in the big ones, major big ones. Oh, darling, the time has come for you to live real for Christ. The time has come. The time has come that we need to be born again. This is high time. Why? Why, Brother Gabriel, you are saying that I need to be born again? Why does it mean to be born again? You must be born again because any child that is born into this world is born into two spiritual worlds. Every person, according to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 1, God spoke to Jeremiah that before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. And I have ordained you. I have set you aside for my purpose. That is clearly to say that before we were born into this life, Romans also tells about that, that he foreknew us. He had pre-knowledge about our lives before we were born. If that is so, then he gave us names before we were born. So every human being born on this earth has God-given name before your mother and your father named you. Beloved, I'm going to reveal some secrets to you today that might change your understanding, the reason why you need to be very serious. There are two spirit beings which are present whenever we are born into this life. When we have been given into our mothers or our parents, there is always one angel from heaven and one angel from hell around us. Therefore, every human being born into this world has a name registered in hell as well as in heaven, right from the birth. When God put the record, Satan also start recording your name. The name that you be given onto this earth is as essential as the parents that you were born into. Some of us were lucky, therefore we have parents that were Christians, and therefore they gave us biblical names. My name is Gabriel. Gabriel means the angel of God who has carried the word of God. The angel that ministered the word of God. According to my dad, that was the name that the angels of the Lord gave unto him to be given unto me when I was in my mother's womb. And to be honest with that, we are lived that name right from birth up to today. To confirm that is scripture. The Bible have given us so many areas. The birth of Jesus Christ, the birth of John the Baptist, the birth of Jacob. Basically, that was where the problem was. The birth of Jacob was a problem. And so we will come back to that. But specifically, the birth of Samson, all the Nazarenes, Samson, Jesus, John the Baptist, their names were given to their parents. And I testify that it is true, because one of my big daughter, when she was in the womb, the Lord gave me a name to give into her. To my ignorance, I refuse to journalize that name. I refuse to write it down before I realize the name has escaped in my mind. The name that God gives is in his holy book, clearly visible in the book of life, as well as in satanic book. If the name that is given to you by God, if your parents are able to tune in and give that name to you, it restricts and restrains Satan from having anything in common with your name to destroy you and to call you. But if you are dedicated in an environment where other worship and all these things are, they give you a different name attached to godly name. My auntie was called Adawa. And therefore my father named me after his sister, and I'm called Adade. I know Adade is a name that Ashanti name, Kwao people name them, where my name comes from. I think Ekwiapim people also name that. It's a common name. One time I found out to know that and that they tend to be other names somewhere, somehow. When it becomes necessary that you need to change your name because your name is other name, please do it. Because those names can have impact over your life. If your name is connected to idols, the angel will disappear without writing down the name. While the names are trying, while demons will take down the name into hell instead. When your parents give you a name and dedicate you to idol right from birth, you are gone. You are gone. This is a spiritual secret. The day that your mother and your father will reject the will of God for your life and straight away dedicate you to demons, please, you are gone. It becomes very necessary that when you become born again, if you need to change the name, change it. I love it that there are other religious people like Muslim, when they become Christian, they change their name and take Christian names. It's very, very necessary. The name of a thing is the thing itself. A name defines an object or the duty or the purpose. Name has something in common with purpose. So if you don't know the purpose of your life, you give names. We give names just as like that. It's high time that after listening to these teachings, I pray that you go to your parents and ask them, where did they get your name from? Because it is necessary. It is very, very necessary. What is happening? It is very, very necessary. Bible had to change names. Why was it necessary that God has to change names? He changed the name of Jacob to Israel because his name was having bad influence over his life. I will come back to that. Beloved, when a person grows up and gets genuinely born again, the blood of Jesus will cover the name written in the book of hell so that a person's name becomes invisible to the agents of darkness but visible in heaven. When you become born again and you take Bible name and you change your name, no longer Adade is not the name that I want you to call me. Don't call me Adade. Call me Gabriel. Because I am not sure of that name. Whenever a believer commits a sin, he has backslided. Any sin that you commit, and therefore your name becomes visible to the kingdom of darkness, but blotted out from the book of life. Revelation chapter 3 verse 5. When you step into sin, right from the beginning I made a statement that to go to heaven is a thought. To go to hell is a thought. Revelation chapter 3 verse 5. God says that I will blot your name out of my book. Warn them. They might be either warm or they might be cold. And since they are not cold nor warm, I will vomit them. I will spit them out. I will blow them out of my book of remembrance. He that overcome the same shall be clothed in the white remnant, and I will not blot out his name out of the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angel. This is Sister Jesus speaking. I will confess, I will pronounce, I will let the Father know. Beloved, we must be ready and be willing to come to God. Whenever a person's name is visible to the kingdom of darkness, that means that person's name is not visible in the sight of God. And you're asking me, brother, what does it cause a person's name to be written or remain in the book of life? The only thing that causes your name to remain in the book of life is holiness, righteousness, and truth, which you and me, we find it very difficult every day. Because we wear sin, we eat sin, we sing sin, we watch sin. To maintain your name in the Lamb's Book of Life 24/7, you need to be covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. You need to be an environment where Jesus can mention and confess your name before his King, because you have lived your life for him. Revelation chapter 3 verse 5. No one's name can be both in heaven, visible in heaven, and visible also in hell at the same time. No. Every now and then, your name is fading. When you live in righteousness, your name is glittering. It is shining in the book of life. And when you step out of holy life a second, this is very difficult for people to understand it. The religious people who want to detect for God, they take it very serious. That pastor, this thing is not biblical. Well, Koku, you can accept it if you want it. Whenever you enter into sin, Satan was perfect in all his ways until sin were found in his thinking, in his thought. Until the day sin was found in him. Not until the day he did sin, but until the day he thought of going to become like God. These are proper teachings. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 7, the narrow is the way, narrow is the road, narrow, 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 narrow. We walk out of the narrow road every day. We step out. You can never be a Christian while you are sinning. There is nothing like that. The day you sin, that day you denounce your Christianity, you become backslider. The day you enter into sin, you are no longer a Christian. Don't call yourself a Christian because you are in the Church of Pentecost. You are in the Church of Latter-day Saint. You are in the Church of this. Don't call yourself, because Christianity is not a church goer. Christianity is a blood-bought person. A person that his life, his soul, his spirit is bought by the blood of the Lamb, covered by the blood of the Lamb, and live by the blood. Whenever your name becomes visible for the kingdom of darkness, the agent of darkness will begin to target you to see when they can strike and kill you before you get the opportunity to repent again. The kingdom of darkness is very, very careful not to kill a person who carelessly, without carrying out a thorough check on his righteousness and holiness status. Satan cannot kill a believer anyhow, because it costs him. Whenever Satan kills a child of God, his spear, his cutlass, his weapon become blind. They can't do anything. They become paralyzed for some time. That is why sometimes God will allow believers to be killed by Satan, when he knows that their job is done. Their activity is over, like John the Baptist. When John was sent to the disciples to come and ask Jesus Christ if he is the Messiah, Jesus said, "Go down for me, because when you go, the day you go, Satan will leave me alone. And I'll be strong and increase in the power and in the might." Before Satan will destroy any person, he needs to make a thorough check if that person is a righteous person. You need not to be afraid of witches and wizards, sister, because if you are living holy life, demons have no power over your life. Let me tell you that. Until you open the door for Satan to attack you, Satan will never have the chance. Your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and the angels are watching you 24/7. They will see to it. The Bible says in the book of Psalms that the angels of the Lord encamp around those who fear God, and they watch them. Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Are you born again? You must be born, reborn again. And you need to maintain your born again life by living holy, righteous life, and being careful to obey all the instructions that God has legislated, even if it will cost you pains. A Christian and a child of God is a person who constantly are being washed by the blood of the Lamb. They stay where the blood can cover, where the blood can protect them. My prayer cannot protect you. It's only the blood of Jesus Christ. I can fast 27 days, 40 days for you, darling. If you don't allow your blood, the blood to cover your life, honey, I can't. Christianity does not depend on papa prayer. It does not depend on mama prayer. Yes, they can bring you to your senses according to Luke chapter number 15. As I taught to you that a prodigal son will come to his senses, but what will bring him to his senses? It might be prayer of a parent. It might be the love of the parent. Because when we studied the book of Luke, we saw that the boy came to his senses and he remembered his father's love. He said, how many food have my father had at home? That even the servant, they eat and throw some away. Oh, look at my father's love. It is extended even to the servants. What about me? Why am I suffering? It is only the love of the Father that can bring a sinner home. It is only the love. And what does that love does? It covers you. It protects you. It provides for you. When you come into the blood of the Lamb, you are protected. You are provided. You are secured. You are not afraid. When you have protection, when you have provision, that is all life is about. Protection and provision. They are two powerful words. And that is in the hands of your maker. When you direct your affair unto him, he will guide you into all truth. You might not need to go through any process. All that you need to do is to stay holy. And to stay holy is to study the word of God. So fast and pray and keep yourself away. What can a man turn away? How can a man turn away from evil doings? By observing the word of God. That is the only way. As you keep yourself according to the commandment of God, heaven will frustrate Satan. Heaven will continue to frustrate Satan so long as your life is covered by the blood of the Lamb. If Satan kill innocent people, hey, those demons will be punished. They will be punished mercilessly in the hands of Satan. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you, never allow yourself to walk in this Christian life thinking that you are not under target. The target of the kingdom of hell is not just to kill people anyhow, but to ensure that that person is being killed, that person who is being killed is an confessed person, a person who has not confessed his sin. That is what I want to see. A person who has not confessed his sin and his soul is already in the hands of Satan. Ladies and gentlemen, every human being on earth had not less than over 70 demons assigned to carefully monitor his or her life from the time of birth. The more you send them to her, the more they come. There is not a single day that Satan has not fashioned his eyes upon the righteous person. Don't live a loose life if you are born again believer. Today I want to concentrate on born again believers. Do not waste your life. Don't sow your garment. Don't sow your garment, because every drip of sin in your garment disqualifies you. It is basically impossible to commit a sin secretly without the knowledge of the kingdom of heaven as well as the kingdom of hell. Why? Because the angels of God are around you, and the angels of Satan are hovering around, depending upon whom you may allow your wishes and your choices to be controlled. My God may overlook your sins, but demons take it into account, every single sin that you commit. Job chapter 1 tells us that in those days when the sons of God met, Satan also went there. And when God saw him, he asked him one question: have you thought of my servant Job? What does it mean? Do you have any report against Job? Have you discovered anything evil in Job's life? Satan is daily walking to and fro. He said, I am walking to and fro. What does it mean? I am working hard to get people to be destroyed. I am working myself hard. Apostle Peter warned us, be vigilant. Be vigilant. Let your eye be open concerning the things and the instructions of God. Because the instructions that you follow determine the future that you create. Whosoever instruction you follow determine where it will lead you, darling. Therefore, be very careful with your choices. Be vigilant, because your adversary, the Satan, the Lucifer, the liar, the evil man, he is walking around like a lion. He is not a lion, but he masquerading himself like a lion. He takes the nature of a lion. What does it mean a lion is? Here he doesn't take instructions. When a lion see a play, no matter what, how big that play is, a lion will fight him. Oh, it is very miserable that a lion can fight elephant and kill elephant. Satan is not a lion. But when we commit sin, we become vulnerable to his attacks. Therefore, we can't defend ourselves. God may overlook your sin, but Satan will never. No sin will pass by that Satan will not. Oh, that is one for us. Woo! Woo! He'll be celebrating. Satan will be celebrating because of your sin. This is why you must stay away from sin at all costs, darling. And ensure that you receive cleansing of the blood of Jesus Christ for unintentional sin. Sin that you don't intend to do. And this is why it is very important that you listen to some teachings like this. That will purge you every day. That will correct you every day. That will walk your way through the wheel of gold. Don't go to these false prophets who are not rebuking sin, because they are not helping you. The motivational speakers of our days are not helping you to come out. Never take the mercy of God for granted. Never. Never. Because if you play with the mercy of God, it will be too late. Stop playing with sin. Abstain yourself from willful sin and unwillful sin. Inasmuch that you can avoid it, do your possible best. If you call yourself at this end time a Christian, hey believers, go to God every day. And go to other churches that you don't like them. Can't you brag, Abraham, because you don't like the way I preach and the way I teach? I said so many things that causes your flesh to boil. And that's what I love. Because when the word of God comes, we swallow it. It's very sweet. But when we swallow it, it becomes bitter in our throat. The word of God is bitter in the mouth of a person who is carrying it. Do you think that it is easy for Paul to deny his lifestyle of Pharisee, killing the disciples, and now the accuser of the brethren has become a defender? The one who was pursuing the believers to kill them. Human being can be changed, but Satan can never change. Be very careful the environment. Be very careful the environment. Quit playing games with your life. Quit lighting up your candle in the wind. Quit lighting up your candle in the wind. It will go off within a twinkle of an eye. Never think that you are strong. Never think that you are strong. Hey, don't become like Samson, who couldn't forfeit the God-given purpose for his life. Samson was called as a deliverer, as a redeemer to deliver the people of Israel from the hands of the Philistines. But because of sin, Samson loved sin. Therefore, he couldn't fulfill his God-given purpose to the full. The mercy of God was upon him. And I believe Samson went to heaven. I believe. Ladies and gentlemen, unless we are free from the clutches of satanic attacks, unless we are free from the satanic desires, motivation, inspiration, we will lose. We will lose. We will lose. We will lose the battle. We will lose the battle. We will lose the battle. The time has come. The time has come that we need to live our life every day for the Lord. Turn with me to the book of James, chapter number 1, verse 27. Book of James 1, 27. Let's study something over there before I take you to the reason why God changed his name. God will change your name because you have become his. Your product will change when your name changes to become God's name. Pure religion and undefiled before God. Do you hear that? Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this. Is this. The religion that God demands from you. The lifestyle that God is demanding from you and me. Is this, to visit the fatherless and the widow in their affliction. Visit those people who don't have fathers. Do you have them around you? What does it mean? Those people who don't have financial support in their life, if you have some. Because fathers are the source and also the sustenance. African fathers were supposed to be leaders. But most of us, our fatherhood ends by conception. I know many Africans who are giving birth and they are not taking care of their children. I fought for my child that I born him out of wedlock. I fought, I went to court for my son. Some friends were asking me, Gabriel, are you stupid? In this country, if you do this, you are putting yourself into trouble. I say, it is my responsibility. And this woman says that she doesn't want me to take care of my son. Why? Because I refuse to live in sin with her. Beloved, there is one thing to give birth to a child and there is one thing to marry the woman. It is two different things. If God tells you don't marry, don't do it. Live by the instructions of God. Don't fear man. I've been there before, so I know what I'm talking about. I didn't marry you. Therefore, I won't give the child to you. No, sister, that boy is my blood. And this sister said, over my dead body. And the word that came out of my mouth is, so shall it be. And it became like that. Be very careful what you say towards a man of God. because his words are recorded. Upon a dead body will you get your son? I said, so shall it be, darling. So shall it be. And the angel straight away, they took it. She called back. Yeah, I know that you are a Christian. I know that. I said, well, darling, it is written. What is written is written. You said so. Do you want it? And if that is how it is, Lord, that is how it's supposed to be. And it became exactly like that. Who killed Lucy? Don't go there. Be very careful the words that you say, because you kill yourself, you destroy yourself. Whenever you speak, angels are already there. They are recording. Hey, she said that she would die and that young man would take care of his son. Beloved, don't joke with God. I've been there before. I'm very, very careful with my confession, because I know the angels of God are there. If you live a holy life, your words will become powerful and dynamic. You curse sickness and they are cursed. You curse diseases and they are cursed. Christians, we don't know what we have. In Christians, we know what we have. The angels are 24/7 around us. Sometimes when I make silly comments, when my wife is around, I say, don't say this, because she's afraid. Recently, I make a comment, and my work colleague was there. I said, no, 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 Pastor, don't say that. I say, I reverse it. I don't know if the angels reverse it for me. Hey! The religion that God is demanding from you is to take care of the fatherless and the widows in their affliction, and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Do you hear that? Unspotted from the world. Anything that the world will spot you, believers. That's why I preach about restitution. Some of you guys, you have given birth in Africa, you don't take care of them, you are going to hell. Do you want me to take care of your children for you? What do you mean? Some call themselves pastors. You don't go to church where they teach you the word of God. You're giving birth to a child, and you've led a child unattended to, and the boy is suffering. When you go to Africa, some children are suffering because of irresponsible fathers. Brother, stop everything. Have you become born again? We call it restitution. Go to that woman. Let her count all the bills that she has paid on behalf of that child. Take it and claim your son. Pay that woman and claim your child. Other than that, if you die as irresponsible father, and straight away, don't spot yourself. Don't spot yourself with this world. Fear. I was afraid that somebody will say that I am the father, and so I decline that I am not a father, and have caused a woman to die. Find out my teachings on that restitution and listen to that. It will help you. Beloved, what am I saying? God wants us to live our life without being spotted with sin. God doesn't want us to spot. He doesn't want us to defile ourselves. God doesn't want us to defile ourselves in any day. 1 Corinthians chapter number 3, the verse number 17. Let's go there. Beloved, live a godly life, taking care of all your responsibilities. Don't leave it in the hands of innocents and people who are not responsible for that of which you have enjoyed. God will hold you responsible, sir. God will hold you. To become a Christian means don't have any sin within your life. And sin is doing what God doesn't accept. Sin is doing what God doesn't affirm. 1 Corinthians chapter number 3, verse 17. What is God required of you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. You, do you know that you are the temple of God? Do you know that your body is of God? And every sin that you commit, every thought of sin that comes into your mind, defiles your body. Do you know that? You are very sensitive. You are very white. Your garment is very pure, like a pure water. And every drop of water, every drop of color, step into white stains, defile your garment. If any man defile the temple of God, another translation says, if any man destroy the temple of God, God will destroy that person, because the God's temple is holy. And that is why Romans chapter 12 said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, with the mercies of God, to present your body holy, pleasing unto God, And this is the reasonable sacrifice. Your life must be a sacrificial life to God. You better not live one day without God. Never live one second without God, because it can cost you. You don't know when God will meet you. But never allow God to meet you in sin, because he can't do anything. God can do nothing about your life when he meets you with sin in your life. Your temple, your body is the temple of God. Your human body, your physical body is the temple of God. That God wants you to become born again and live as his son. The angels of heaven, they keep their holiness and their righteousness 24/7. Beloved, it is your responsibility. It is not God's responsibility. Your holiness life comes by your choices. And God can never overrule your choices. There is no way that God can overrule your choices. That makes God very weak. A brother asked me, is God, what is the word that he used? Is God desperate? Yes, he is. God is desperate. God is desperate. He's standing there and he doesn't know what to do, because he is a God that works with principles. He is principle God. If God is not desperate, why can God sit there? For Satan literally abhorred the plans that he will cause Adam and Eve to sin against God, and God has to kill Jesus Christ. Don't you think it paid God to kill Jesus? He did. He has to make a risk to risk his only son. God is desperate. Your will make God desperate. You and me will put God in desperation. Become born again. Live as a Christian and stop playing games with your belief system. Condoning and conniving with sin. Copying and imitating sin. Oh, sister, this one did it. Don't allow any human being to become your yardstick. Never allow any human being to become the measure of your holiness. Never let Jesus be the measure. If Jesus becomes the measure of the holiness, you won't buy and sell anything which is not of God. You go to him every day. You go to him every day and you pray to him. And when you pray to him, he will answer you. And therefore, you will not continue to fight against holiness and righteousness. When I see Christians struggling with the teachings of the holiness and righteousness, I am amazed. I am surprised. Why? Because Jesus said in John chapter number 10 verse 27, I know my flock and they know me. I know their voice and they know my voice. Argumentative cease when you hear the voice of God yourself. That is why I implore you to come before him. Come before him every day, because he wants to keep us in that perfect condition. He doesn't want us to fly with any bird. He doesn't want us to fly with any other bird, because every bird has their characteristics. He wants us to fly together with him. He is the white eagle. He is the eagle. In animal, in the bird's kingdom, he is an eagle. When you come to the animal kingdom, he is the lion and the lamb. The lion rules, the lion wins, conquer, but the lamb rules. So we need to have these three animals within us. We need to have the lion character, we need to have the eagle character, and we need to have the lamb character. The eagle is to fly higher and make your nest in the high places that no hawk or no animal can rise up to that level. Rise up with those who are making heaven. Those who are preaching holiness and righteousness at this end time. Don't buy any seed. Don't buy anything from the so-called motivational speakers. Because they are the children of Satan that will pamper you. It is okay to stay here. Don't go far. You know, God accepts everybody, you know. God will love you, you know. What you are going through is just a time. I mean, it will pass away. Hey, sir. Tell me it is a time. When does that time begin? Tell me, and the door has been opened. Unless you close that door. a door of sin had opened. Unless and until that door is closed and shut forever, those things will continue to be pre-occurring. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Did you hear that? Who is an unbeliever? Unbeliever is any person that doesn't respect Bible as the final instructions. Unbeliever is a person that doesn't practice Jesus Christ. Any person that claims to be a Christian is different from a believer. Christianity is different from believer. Every human being that was born into a Christian home call him or herself a Christian, but she might not be a believer. So Jesus is commanding us, don't be equally yoked. Never have anything. Don't fly with them. Don't mingle with them. Don't have their parties. Never have their part. I think that is why. Let me go to Message Bible. I would love what Message Bible will tell me here. Beloved, it is time. It is time. It is time to become born again again. It is time to become born again again. Let us stop messing up our righteousness. Let us stop selling ourselves very cheap to sin. Let us stop. Let us stop and run unto the Messiah, the giver of life, and stay with him. Let us stay. Let us stay with him. Let us lay our head on him, and he will cherish us and feed us in his will. Message Bible. According to 2 Corinthians chapter number 6. Don't become partners with those who reject God. Did you hear that? Don't become partners. Many people have rejected God in our modern days. They have rejected the ways of God. They have rejected the principles of God. They have rejected the counsel of God. Never have them as friends. How can you make partnership out of right and wrong? How can it be? How can you make partnership with the tree of knowledge of good and evil? Hey, Adam and Eve made it. Go to Adam and Eve and let them tell you the instruction. I quite remember I was reading the book and a man went to heaven and he met Adam. And he said, Adam, what will you tell us? He said, go and tell the people on this earth that they shouldn't sell the paradise for wilderness. They shouldn't sell paradise for wilderness. Because I gave up paradise. I gave up the Garden of Eden for wilderness. And I paid the price dearly. My children started killing themselves. Hey! If Adam is to stand today in your face, he will tell you, don't buy. Don't be partner with right and wrong. Never! Never! Because they are dangerous. Little right, little wrong. You don't know when you are biting stones. You will never know. That is not partnership. That is war. Do you hear what he said? It is a warfare. When you expose yourself to such environment, become born again, real. Become real born again. Because there is a warfare. There is a warfare. Tomorrow sick, yesterday good. To every day up and down. Your life will never be stable if you live with and partnership with sin in your life. Sin can be what you wear. Sin can be what you watch. Sin can be what you hear. Sin can be what you smell. Sin can be where you are and where you go. Sin can be a thought, and that thought will position you. So in a position where you find yourself, sin is very closer to you. Avoid it. Your body shouldn't become an agent of sin. Is light your best friend with dark? Are you having light and dark mixed together? Have you ever seen it before? Does Christ go strolling with the devil? And did you ever see Jesus walking hand in hand with Satan? Hey, Satan, come on, let's come, join me. No! Whenever Jesus saw Satan coming, he drifted his direction. He changed his direction. You will ask me, why would Jesus not kill him? That was not his duty when he came first. He didn't come to kill him. He came to kill his desire in your heart. And he is doing that. Jesus can kill Satan in your life, but not Satan outside. Does it make sense? Yes. The word of God killed the desire, the instructions. Stop every operation of demonic work in your life. That is what the word of God does. God will never kill Satan on your behalf, but he will kill him in your life. What does it mean to kill? To stop feeding it. Satan will never have, sin will never rule over your mortal body, because your body belongs to God. Do you trust and mistrust? Have you seen trust and do trust and mistrust hold hands? Who will think of setting up a pagan idol in God's holy temple? But yet it is there. 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 There are many paganism in Christianity today. We have blended the two and we don't know where we are. Yay! What are we? Where are we? Each one of us. Where are we? Our body has become the temple of Satan and the temple of God. Little God, little Satan. Little demons, little witches. Little world, little Christianity. And we have blended the two. I need to dress. A sister told me, but Pastor, if we don't dress that, our husband, when we are walking around, they look aside. Foolishness. Because of your husband, you're going to hell. No matter what your unbeliever husband, if you can dress nakedness and follow after him, when he see another naked woman, he will stop and watch. Because that is what sin does. Sin tell us every day, this is better. This look different. And to be honest with you, every human being look differently beautiful. But they perform the same job. It's the same work, the same function that every beauty performs. Don't allow Satan to deceive you. Don't allow Satan to deceive you. So long as the mind, the brain is working. When opportunity is given to two people, the legitimacy may be different. The time and the season that one will process his things might be different. But definitely we might get an equal result. Even if not equal, it might be the same at the end of the day. Beloved, be very careful to say that I will live in them and move into them. I will be their God and they will be my people. That's what God wants us to be. So leave the corruption and the compromising. Leave it. Leave it. Don't compromise. Don't compromise. Stop compromising. Stop corrupting yourself and compromising. Because my husband won this. I met a woman in London, and funny thing that she said, because my husband want a white, a fair lady. I say, you are blind. You are blind fish, woman. And such a dark woman. She is even darker than I. Very black woman. And she is bleaching. Are you not ashamed? And go and see her skin. Ugly, stinking, smelling, dirty. Every person that bleaches her body is going to hell, let me tell you straight away, if you don't know it. It's abomination. You put God under question. You question God. Why God didn't make you? You curse God. Every question is a curse unto God. That's why God doesn't want you to do all these things. God is not foolish as we are. God is not blind as we are. If you have lived with white people before, you will accept what you have. You will appreciate what God has given unto you. Blind, 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 and your pastors are not telling you that you are going to hell with that situation. Sometimes when I meet them, I look at them and say, you look ugly, sister. You look very ugly. And they are smelling with this bleaching soap and cream. And it's as much as you smell to me. That is what the God feels. Oh, bon. Bonia, my hobon, sister. Kurasi seven away yen jai. Jai 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 nedo ko hell mini aba. Men come one inje. I want you to be angry at sin. I want you to hate sin. Hate sin. Hate sin. If there is anything that you need to hate in your life, it's sin. Your pastor is not telling you. Because, oh God, don't let me go there. I nearly said one thing. Jesus, have mercy upon you. Do you know that your body belongs to God and God wanted it so? And therefore, never sell yourself so cheap. He wants to dwell in that body. And when God comes in your body and sin is there, he can't stay there. Don't link up yourself with those who are polluting their physical body, their mind. Pollution. Don't live with the polluted areas. Because he wants us for himself. He made you for himself. And he wants you to remain for himself. Anything that you add to what he has made, you accuse him and you curse him. Anything that you add to your hair, you curse God. Anything you add to your body, you curse God. I will be a father to you. You'll be sons and daughters to me. That is what the word of the master says. He wants to be God. He wants to be God in your life and in my life. Is he really God? Have you totally given up your life to this God that I'm talking about this morning? If not, what are you waiting for? If not, becoming reborn again. Stop playing church. The time to play church is over. Ladies and gentlemen, that time is too gone. It is far spent. It's yesterday then. Gone are the days. 1 Corinthians chapter number 6, the verse 19 to 20. Let's listen to what the Message Bible says. There is more to sex than mere skin on skin. Did you hear that? Some of us, we don't know. When two male meet, when two female meet, when a male and a female meet, and they have their body skin to skin, sex is more spiritual mystery as physical fact. You consider it, oh, it's fun. It's not fun. Sex is not fun. Sex is spiritual transformation or exchange. There is a mystery. As written in scripture, the two will become one. Did you hear that? The two will become one. Whenever you meet with a person, you become one. Since we went to become spiritually one with the master, we must not pursue the kind of sex that avoids commitment and intimacy with the king. Any form of sexual relationship, inappropriate sexual relationship with yourself, defiles your relationship with God. Now people are sleeping with animals, those who are sleeping with themselves, men are sleeping. And sexual sin is one of the highest sin in this end time that believers and Christians are being swept away because you watch the pornography and you do all kind of silly and immoralistic things. One of my daughter asked me, Daddy, so is oral sex sin? I said, darling, it is sin. God did not create your mouth for that thing. God did not create your hand for that thing. God did not create your nose for that thing. It is the devil who has implemented all these things. Oh, my worry, I'm a married person, so I can watch pornography. Sister, why don't you make one and give it? Why don't you film you and your husband and go and give it to your pastor? The devil is a liar. Do you want anybody to see your nakedness? If you can watch pornography, that means you want somebody also to watch your nakedness. Aren't you ashamed? Ladies and gentlemen, let us come before God. Because your church is not preaching all these things to you. Watching pornography will take you straight to hell. Any form of pornography is dangerous. Any form of sexual relationship, apart from a husband and wife meeting, when a man is lying on top, that's it. Even back, I don't think God accepted the back once. Jesus have mercy. Some of you, your husband want to meet with you, and I'm not interested. I am not in the mood. It is dangerous, sister. It is very, very dangerous. You take yourself away from the covenant of God. The moment you deny your husband that pleasure, you accept Satan to sleep with you. And that particular moment, you are gone. That is deep. Unless you are in your menstrual period. I am tired. You are giving yourself your open door for Satan to attack your relationship unaware. How many times have God revealed so many things to me? Sometimes I just watch. I don't tell my wife. I don't tell her. Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the spiritual warfare 24/7. Therefore, we must be very, very, very careful. So one of the painful aspects is when a husband wants to meet the wife. And the wife will tell her, I'm tired. I am this. It's like when you are thirsty and you're asking me to give you water. And I'm saying, oh, my hand cannot reach there. We are lying on bed. And the water is just behind my reach. You are thirsty to die. And I am asking you to give me the water. And you say, oh, I'm sorry. I can't stretch for my hands. Do you have any reason why you deny your husband? Why you deny your wife sexual pleasure? God gave it to us. Apart from having children, it is one thing that brings us together to become one. It is one thing that makes us one. My sisters can cook for me. My mother can cook for me. My friends can cook for me. But this particular thing, I can only do it with one person. Let it be registered in your mind. Never give up your body for any person. In a naked form, while people are watching your naked pictures, you blind Christian sisters who post your pictures, naked pictures and dirty pictures, have naked pictures in. Some people, they do it as provocation. Sometimes some of my friends, as if they are doing Gabriel. I have my own battle to fight. That is your cause. That is your choice. You can do whatever you want. I preach the truth to you. Woe unto me if I don't speak the truth. Woe unto me. Because I feel headache if I don't speak the truth. The kind of self that can never become one. Be very careful. Be very careful. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 to 20. Is what I'm reading. There is a sense in which sexual sins are different from all others. Why? Because every sin that a man commits is not in his body. But sexual sin remains in your skin. In sexual sin, we violate the sacredness of our own bodies. Do you hear that? The sacred, how holy our body is. So any sexual sin defiles your body. And Pastor Chris will tell me oral sex is not evil. If this man is not evil himself, then who is? I am boldly to say, because he said it has been recorded and I can prove it. Those people who are going to his church, I warn you, I don't hate that man. I don't need nothing from him. I warn you, if you are in such churches, run away and go for Bible-based church. Look at his church. They show only his videos, and you watch them. You are frustrated. All the people who are under Christ, who are under TB Joshua ministry, you are all going to hell. I'll always say it. I hear somebody say, "Hey, so for Gabriel, what do you want to say? Sister, I just mean throw. Who hear me? Me therefore, who hear me? Your soul is going to hell. Let him come and kill me, and you go to heaven. Why?" How can people do all these things against the children of God? And there are many of them in Nigeria. There are many of them in Ghana. And we are sleeping with these men. Because when we become one with their teaching, we are sleeping with Satan. When we become one with them, any person that you become one with his ideas, with his information, you are sleeping. Sexual relationship is not only physically. Sexual relationship, God, when God speaks about sexual relationship, my relationship with Jesus Christ is a sexual relationship. You don't know. The bond between a man and a woman is like the bond between God and the soul of human being. And therefore, whosoever you attach yourself with, if that person is demonic, definitely you are selling your soul to Satan. Become reborn again. Run away from these false pastors. Run away. Because where you go to church is as important as where you sleep and what you watch 24/7. Don't you see that? You can live however you please, squandering what God paid such a huge price for. Holiness and righteousness. Your body is sacred place, the place where the Holy Spirit dwells. Don't you know that? And therefore, whenever you come into contact with any person who is not God, any person who is not holy, you buy and sell with people every day unaware. You buy and sell with them. Your attitude sell. Be very careful. Be very careful, because you can't squander in your holy prayer, your holy nature, and think that you can get it back, because Jesus paid a price, a huge price for that, and he's weeping every day. Ladies and gentlemen, you must say that, well, this thing is not nothing. Satan lies that. When you overlook things that are valuable in the hands of God and you give it to Satan, why do you give things that belong to children to dogs? The prodigal son, the Bible said that he would have wished to have the pig food, but it was not given unto him. When you have sinned, when you are in sin, sin deny you of your pleasure. When you are in holiness, holiness will bring, sin will give you everything that you want. Half it for free. Half it for free. Buy one and get one free. The devil is a liar. Hey, me the ma pem you, and your man a pel, Satan everywhere, because he went in Ephra. Now we did match, we did match, we did match. Nyan samba aku kure ni uti. Wawalen so sorry, man kwa na udu mochi. Sorry, na kwa tina swanda na uba sorry kwenye. Kwa tina na swanda na uba sorry organ, piano. Wani ne fira kwa ku. Biri, and stop this foolishness, because you are going to hell. Your pastor will not tell you. Pastor didn't see it. Jesus saw it and Satan saw it. He will destroy your life one day. When said people that, oh, that brother was very, oh, he was a singer, he was a worship leader. He was the one that played our drums, he was a one. Yeah, be very careful, young man. Be very, very careful. Be very careful and stay from sin. You can't play with your holiness. Don't become blind like that. I've been there before, that's why I'm telling you this. I have been there before. Married woman. Those who are not married, I don't put much blame on them. I excuse them sometimes because of the pressure. But you, be very careful. You have every way to say no to sin. Never, never buy into that, because you might pay a huge price. A dear price. Don't let sin meet you. Don't let Christ meet you, sin in your hands. Because whenever sin meets you, on the road, on the narrow road, he takes you out. And when holiness meets you on the broad way, he will take you out. Anytime you sin, you fall into the major road. Be very careful and be rest assured. Never sell your body to sin. Never sacrifice your body. Never make your body property which is belong to Satan. Because God owns your whole body. So let people see God. And through your body, let people see God through your body, through your ways of life. Let people see God and acknowledge his presence in you. James chapter 4, verse number 4. Let's go there. Beloved, I preach different gospel. Are you sure? It's not different. This is the gospel that I wanted to hear when I was a boy. I wanted to hear it when I was in another church. Brother, stop sinning. You can't tell me stop sinning easily. Let me know the consequence of sin. If I know the reward. If I know the reward. And I wasn't afraid until the reward came. And it wasn't pleasant reward. James chapter 4 verse 4. James chapter 4. The Message Bible takes us to verse 6. So let me read it. You are cheating on God. Did you hear that? You are cheating on God. Hey, if all you want is your own way, why do we cheat God? My way, I want it on my way. I want to do it on my way. And that is what the Bible of Satanists is. Do what you want. Never pay attention to God. You are flirting with the world every day. Every chance you have. You are flirting with the world. Now Facebook, I have to print no picture, no photo. Print no there, no there. Better so. I never change that for or they say Facebook. Why are they? Because yeah, men manage to deja, and they are all sleeping with you. Do you know how many men who are flirting with you? And every person that flirts with your soul, Satan is giving you a reward in hell. Satan will give you a reward unless you become reborn again. Your pastor will not sell you because he enjoys it likewise. When she see your uncovered neck, this is the blessing from Satan, because you are cheating God. Can you cheat on your husband? Have you ever cheated on your husband? You're a prostitute. Prostitute cheat on your husbands. Are you cheating God? You are a prostitute in the hands of God. How many of us are we? Billions of us. And we think that we are God. Let us surrender our will and our ways unto God. The way we dress, the way we walk, the way we talk, the way we see things, and the way we judge things. Flirting with the world every chance you get, you end up enemy of God and his ways. You become an enemy of God. You become an enemy of God. Hates you. He hates you. Now he is not calling you that he hates you. He is calling you are under the wrath of God. Somebody will say, does God hate somebody? Yes. He said, I hate the sinners. I will never have them. I will never have them in my kingdom. If you hate him, he will hate you. God doesn't promote hatred. But if you set up, he will accept it. He can never force his love on you. Do you suppose God doesn't care? He cares. Do you think that God doesn't care? He really cares. You are valuable in his hands. Become a reborn again and stop playing games with your Christian life. Stop walking like a prostitute on the street in your churches. Now most of the churches have become a prison yard. Most of the churches are discotheque. Hey! Disco kura man dressing because I artist, sorry demon. Makeups are makeups, eyelashes are earrings. No, na ba kubi yecha. Say no more year years, no more year them see money ne guas dear. Monty mon fere. Hey, yes, semi. Yeah, my yabo bunny. Oh, my yabo bunny, ye hinimu. Edin kawashimu. Hey! What do we call heaven? If you understand the meduro, can you have a family called dad? I can give you my son and need a dad. Jesus, have mercy. Those who have pierced their nose and putting rings there, slave to sin, slave to hell, you are going there. Those who are bleaching and they are like white people. Hey! And you are ashamed. Your mind is not a white mind. Your white is a black mentality. If there is anything that you need to bleach it, you need to bleach your mind. You need to bleach your mind, not your skin. Bleach your mind, darling. That is what God accepts. Bleach your mind with the word of God. Purge it. Come before God and say, God, purge me. Cleanse me inside, not outside. God is fiercely jealous. He is a fiercely jealous lover. What he gives in love is far better than anything else you will find. And what God gives with his lovers is better than anything else that this world can give you. Everything that you are taking from the world is not in your system. They are destroying your system. You need to come into the knowledge that God goes against the willful proud. God give grace to the willing, humble people. This morning, this afternoon, wherever you're listening to me from, it is my cry. I'm giving the first part of becoming reborn again. Stop fooling yourself. Stop playing games with God, because you're playing game with your own soul. The soul that sinneth, the same shall die. God will never reward your iniquity with good, because God can never be mocked. We are mocking God too much. And the time has come that we need to come before God to allow Him to change our name.
I have a Father. He calls me His own. He will never leave me, no matter where I go. He knows my name. He knows my every thought. And He sees each tear that falls. And He leads me where I go.
He hears you when you call. 1 John chapter number 2, verse 15 to 17. Love not the world, says the Lord. Don't love this world. The ways of this world, the ways and manner, the way and manner this world operates, the way and manner the worldly people dress, the way and manner the worldly people think, the way and manner the worldly people judge. Na say I asorin there, eh, obi ntimi judge obi, akosi anyame nkwa na judge o, na nyame asem be judge o. Sabu Gabriel me judge o, me di nyame asem na echirechire wo. Oh, what I'm doing, I'm not judging you, I'm not being judgmental, but I'm revealing the mind and the thought of God concerning your ways to you. You don't know what God thinks. You don't know how God sees things. Because your pastors and your bishops and your deacons and your teachers, Bible teachers, are not teaching you these ways. Because they are living in glass houses, therefore they are not afraid to throw stones. You go away from them. But I don't depend upon your money. I just want to depend upon your soul. If you die today, where will you be? If you die tonight, sister, are you sure that God, you know God, you love the world too much? You are fashion, the person that follows fashion. You are always following the media. Hey, I need to hear. Cast all this rubbish because they are leading you astray. And what pamon to man and what twa. Unya maybe a Africa come do mumunye bianini. Your sister's children in Africa. I mean I'm gonna go for mama womo. If you are with me womo and kebab wow, can you be shrow? Attend to the widows and the orphans, the needy in your family, and stop buying clothes. I've spoken to myself, Gabriel, it is finished. I'm not going to buy clothes again. My money is not going to buy clothes. I hope I will stick to that. Beloved, let us use our money for purpose. I want to save my money, and whenever I hear that somebody is having problems, I prefer sending that money to the person as God touches me. Beloved, let us do what God is calling us to. Broad is the way that leads to hell, and it is called worldly. That Broadway is worldly. The cosmos, the way and manner the world they practice their things. The Bible said that love not the world, love not the world or the ways, the program, the activities, the plans, the occasion. The services, the favor, love of the world squeezes out the love of the Father. Do you know that? It dries it up. It dries, it squeezes. It dries it up. It becomes dry up, dry up, dries up, it dries up. The love of this world will squeeze out the love of the Father practically. Everything that goes on in the world, wanting your own way. Everything that goes on in the world wants you to live your way outside God's will. Every program, every activity, every design us to go outside the ways of God. Thank be to Jesus Christ that He gave us His word. He sent your word to heal our disease. You are the Lord, my healer. You are the Lord, the healer to me. Jesus,
You are the Lord, my healer. In the name of Jesus, as you are listening to the truth, may you be healed. You sent your word and you healed my disease. I cast and I curse every sickness. I curse leukemia. I curse cancer. I curse ulcer. In the name of Jesus, I curse every pain. I curse it. I curse it right now. I pray in the name of Jesus, as the word of God is throwing light, may you cry for forgiveness and repentance, and the time of refreshment may step into your spirit. May you be healed from the sins of this world. May you be brought back to the narrow path. May you be taken away from the hands of the wicked into the hands of the righteous God, who judge righteously. May he send his word to bring you home. In the name of Jesus, it belongs to you because of the price that Jesus paid on the cross. Declare to yourself that healing belongs to me because of what Jesus Christ has done. Salvation belongs to me. Deliverance belongs to me because of the blood that Jesus shed on the cross for me. I am free. I am free. Free at last. Free at last. In Jesus' name. Insomnia is getting out of your body. In the name of Jesus. Lack of blood. In the name of Jesus. Any transfusion that has to be taken spiritually, I command it to be done in Jesus' name. Pat-ko-ta-ra-ba-ba. I resist demonic activity over your life. I take you out of darkness and I bring you into divine light. Into divine light. Into divine light. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. May the Lord go before you as a consuming fire and destroy, destroy, destroy every pole that have been built around your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Kurahandori musaba handiri moshika balazandiri moshandaya. Lila Baba's depression is taken off from you. Depression, in the name of Jesus, I bring the spirit of depression out of your heart. Every confusion, any uncertainty, I come to you in the name of Jesus and I produce clarity of thought into your spirit. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Beloved, all that I want to tell you this morning is do your possible best to present your body as a living sacrifice. Shun away from your own ways. Shun away from the ways of the flesh and be desirous to appropriate yourself to impress God with your everyday life. Has nothing to do with the world, but had everything to do with the Father. Never isolate yourself from the Father, but isolate or distance yourself from the world and all that it is wanting from you. The want of this world, the ways of this world, is the way into hell. But whoever does the God's will, God will set eternity for that person. Do you want to go with the Lord? Do you want the Lord to be your God? When you come to him, he will change your name. When you come to him, he will change your name. Ladies and gentlemen, God is requiring holiness and righteousness. This world has nothing good for us. This world has nothing good for us. This world has nothing good for us. And therefore, let us come before him and let us be real. Let us be real. For we died in sin and our life is hidden with Christ Jesus. Our life is hidden in Jesus Christ. Colossians 3 verse 3. Beloved, we were dead in trespasses. We were dead in trespasses. But we need to come before God every day seeking him. Every day. Every day seeking him. Apostle Paul said in 2 Corinthians chapter number 2 verse 11 that we will not be ignorant because we know the devices of the Satan. My message is to open your understanding for you to know the devices of the enemy. that you might be able to turn your life unto Christ. You might be able to turn your life unto Christ, that your life will be His. Becoming reborn again. Stop deceiving yourself and deceiving God. Stop deceiving yourself. Because basically you can deceive human beings. You can't deceive Satan. Neither can you deceive God. Commit all your ways unto God, and He will direct your path. Commit all your ways unto God, and He will direct your plans. Never make a step without Him. Never think that He cannot see you. God sees your thought. He doesn't see your physical body. He sees your thought, and your thought defines you in His presence. When you stand before God, what describes you? Ladies and gentlemen, we declare what God has revealed. What God has revealed to us through the servants that Satan has used, and eventually they come out and expose the works of Satan. God reveals His word to us through His children that has taken to heaven and hell, that they are revealed the secret and the scar that people are suffering from. Ladies and gentlemen, we are not here to scare you, but we are here to make things clearer, that you buckle up your sandals, and that your Christian journey will be very, very straightforward, and that God's name will be glorified. Beloved, there is a name that God has for you. There is a name that God has for you. Does He have your name written in His book? Does He got your name in His book? Watch out for the second part of this message. I'm going to reveal so many secrets to you that you might be able to understand how necessary it is to take your name from the book of Satan and write your name in the book of life, the Lamb book of life. May the Lord open your understanding. May He bring you closer and closer as you desire to live for Him. Nothing less than righteousness and holiness that will make a place for you.
God to make a way where there seems to be no way. He was in way you cannot see. He will make a way for you. He will be your God. Hold you closer to His side with love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. He will make a way. By a road in the wilderness He leads you. Rivers in the desert will I see. Heaven and earth will fade. By His word will still remain. He will do something new today. So God will make a way where there seems to be no way.
God wants to make a way in your life. Maybe you are tired and say, Brother Gabriel, I am one of the kind of Christians who have been tossed to and fro. I've been going from pastors to pastors, but none of them have been able to help me.
Like a woman on the well, searching for the thing that could not satisfy. But when I hear my Savior calling from far away, never did I say no, fill my cup, Lord. I'm lifting up, Lord, come and quench the testing of my soul. Bread of heaven, fill me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up and make me whole.
You might be the reason why this message was given, that you want God to fill your cup. You're tired. Today you want to cancel your name from that book of demons and bring your name in the book of life. There have been persistent and consistent sickness that happens to you every now and then. And you know that the moment you go close to sin, you go to your boyfriend, you go to your fiancé, you kiss him, you sleep with him, you have this problem. The moment you cheat God, Satan strike in. Why don't you stop cheating God? Why don't you stop? Cheaters will never succeed. Sin. When you cheat God with sin, you bring the judgment of God. You promote sin and Satan to activate his powers in your life. I want you to welcome this Jesus into your life. Let him change every area of your life. And live for him for real. And your life will never be the same again. Do you want to pray with me and say, Lord Jesus, thank you for your word. Thank you because you love me. And you die on the cross. You shed your blood that my sins can be washed away. I believe the sacrifice that you made on the cross for me. I therefore confess with my mouth that you are God that died and rose again. I invite you into my life. Come into my life. Be my Lord and my personal Savior. And save my soul from every rotten sin. Grant me your Holy Spirit. Let him live inside of me, that I will live the rest of my life to honor him. I thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Beloved, if you have prayed that prayer, I'm here to assure you that the merciful God, who judges not as human beings, has broken every covenant relationship as you have denounced the works of Satan and continue to denounce them. Maybe this prayer might not be enough. You need to weep before God and cry. And I see you cry and say, Lord, forgive me. For I have made you too small in my life. I've denied you. Forgive me. I lift my hands with my heart and with my voice. And I say, be magnified.
Be magnified, O Lord. You are highly exalted. And there is nothing you can do. Hold my soul on you. Be magnified, O Lord. Be mag.
He's a covenant breaker. Father, I stand in the name of Jesus and I declare your people to be free, to be set free from every confusion. As many who are in a very critical condition that they need your hand, I send your hand to go and touch them. Heal their marriage, heal their life, save their soul from the wrath of the enemy. In the name of Jesus, set your people free. Set your people free that they can live their life to please you. I honor you because you deserve that. I worship you because you are worthy for that. Blessed be to your holy name. Thank you. Oh yes, I send a spirit of joy coming to somebody's life. Yes, I send a spirit of joy. Yes, yes, yes. Receive it in Jesus' name. It is done. It is them. I send the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. Be imparted into your spirit because you have made yourself available for that. May the Lord God bless you and keep you. May he cover you that the enemy will never find your way anywhere. May God look on your way in Jesus' name. Be blessed. Look for a Bible-based church. Change your church if it is necessary. Find a pastor or a teacher that will teach you the ways of God. If you don't have any place of worship, you can come to our website, www.godswordforus.com or www.endtimeradio.com. You can get us 24/7. These messages are free. You can download them from godswordforus.com. You can download it and give it to your sister, your brother who want to listen. And I'll be very pleased. Above all, you can meet me on Facebook 24/7. I'm there. My Facebook name is Gabriel Pastor Adade. I'll be there to answer questions. If you have any question, maybe I've said something here that you don't understand, please come there.
put the question on me, and I will get chance and time to explain things to you. Or maybe you go to church, you went to church, and the preacher was saying something contrary to what I'm saying. Please come and let us argue together in, by the word of God. Let us come and agree on holiness and righteousness teachings. Not every church is ready for that, but every soul wants that. But not everywhere can you get it. You can get it only here. I give it for free. May God bless you. Until you meet me again this afternoon, I'm going to give you the second part of this message. Please listen to the second part. Becoming born again for real. May God richly bless you. God bless you.